Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Fungus-like protists. Okay, fungus-like protists, they share many similar features with fungi. Like fungi, they are heterotroph, meaning they must obtain their food outside of their cell. So, heterotroph, they will get the food from dead material or organic material. So, these fungi-like protists, the characteristic is much resemble fungi, such as they are having cell wall like fungi, and they normally do not move. Okay, but some of the species, they develop movement at some point in their life. Okay, why fungus like? These protists, they resemble fungi because they are not photosynthetic. It means they cannot produce their own food. Okay, some of these protists, they call a thread, they have a thread-like structure that call hyphae. So this hyphae is also found in fungus. Because of these two criteria, the protists classify under fungus-like protists. The other character of these protists, they have centrioles. Centrioles is a function to produce spindle fiber that helps in chromosome separation during cell division. And these centrioles are found lack in fungi. The other criteria is these protists like fungi, they have a cellulose as the component of their cell wall. Meanwhile, fungi has chitin. So there are three phyla that we are going to be discuss: plasmodial slime mold, cellular slime mold, and water molds. The first fungi-like protist is plasmodial slime mold, or phylum Myxomycota. So the feeding stage is plasmodium. So make sure you don't confuse. This plasmodium is not similar as a plasmodium that cause malaria in human. So the feeding stage we call plasmodium. So these slime mold, they are unicellular but multinucleate. Multinucleate mean within one cell they have more than one nucleus. So this is unicellular with multinucleate. And the structure is slimy, and they live, or they can be found on the stream, over them, leaf litter, and etc. So stream mean very small or narrow river, and leaf litter in Bahasa means the daun sampah. Okay, and then this plasmodia, how they grow? Okay, when it live in one area, okay, they start to creeping. Okay, creeping means menjala. Okay, so the creeping will form a network. So that is how the plasmodia separate or become larger. So the mode of nutrition, they ingest bacteria, they ingest the yeast, okay, and spores and other decaying organic matter. So the mode of nutrition is heterotroph. They need other organism or that material. So how this plasmodia reproduce? Okay, they produce haploid spore within sporangia when insufficient food on and moisture. So the mode of reproduction is by producing spores, which is similar to fungus. When the condition is favorable, favorable means there is enough water, there is enough light, and very suitable to live, the haploid spore will germinate. Germinate means start to grow and act as gamete and fuse to form a zygote. So this is the way they ingest, they reproduce, they get the nutrition, and how they enlarge the network. This is the example of reproductive bodies, or we call as sporangia, of the plasmodial slime mold. Okay, the species is Stenomyces sp. Okay, this is observed under 20 times of magnification. So this is the bodies of the sporangia. So from the sporangia or the stalk here, so there will be released a spore from here. Another example of a plasmodial slime mold is Physarum polycephalum. Okay, so this from this picture you can see the organism. Okay, this creep, okay, creep on the rocks, eh, and then it forming a network like structure. So this is the way the plasmodial slime mold they form a network. Okay, the reproduction of the plasmodial slime mold, okay, they producing spores. Okay, so from this diagram you can see the pink area and blue area. So both of these area are different in terms of their structure and their gametophyte, okay, or their genotype. So we go first to the pink structure from feeding plasmodium. Okay, feeding plasmodium, which is 2N, okay, the genotype is 2N or diploid, say they will form a mature plasmodium which is preparing to fruit. Okay, mature means they are already mature and good enough to prepare for the young sporangium or young spores. So they will develop into young sporangium here, and then this young sporangium later on will form into mature sporangium. When they already in mature sporangium, all the mature sporangium will undergo meiosis process. So remember the meiosis. When meiosis process happen, what will produce is 4 daughter cell, which is haploid. 4 haploid daughter cell. From each spores, okay, each mature spores, they will form into 4 haploid daughter cell. Now we go into the blue area. In blue area, all the genotype in haploid compared to the pink area, which is diploid. So these spores, these haploid spores, okay, when there is favorable condition, there is enough water, there is enough place to live, they will start to germ, to start germinate, to start to grow. So these spores, either it will form into amoeboid cell or into flagellated cell. It can be both. And from amoeboid cell also can change into flagellated cell. Same goes to flagellated cell will turn into amoeboid cell by any chance. So it can be happen in nature. So from these two cells, amoeboid cell and flagellated cells, okay, later on they will do the syngamy. So the syngamy or fertilization. So amoeboid cell will syngamy with amoeboid cell, flagellated cell will syngamy with the flagellated cell. So this fertilization will produce a zygote, which is 2N. Okay? From haploid into zygote. So in this reproduction cycle, it is also called alternation of generation. Mean there is alternate in generation of diploid and haploid. That's why the diagram separate the pink area and blue area. So from the pink area, you can different it by having diploid genotype. And the structure of the organism is in mature or in sporophyte. We call it as sporophyte. Okay, sporophyte means the whole plant. Okay, the actual structure of the plant. The blue area is the gametophyte. Gametophyte mean in the form of gamete. Okay. For the second phylum, Acrasiomycota or cellular slime mold, okay, the feeding stage of this mold is an individual amoeboid cell that behave as solitary organism. So this cellular slime mold is more resembled to protozoa compared to fungi because most of the life stage is spent as an amoeba cell. So this amoeboid cell, they move to get the food, okay? And then that's why the cellular slime mold is considered as protozoa, more to protozoa compared to fungi. So the each amoeboid have haploid cell and they reproduce by binary fission like amoeba. When the moisture and food become inadequate, the cells start to aggregate to 100,000s that we call a pseudoplasmodium. And each of the cells retain their individual identity. So the structure at the right side is the structure of pseudoplasmodium. When one unicellular cell, they start to aggregate and enlarge, forming this structure. The pseudoplasmodium construct a fruiting body that bears spores. So this pseudoplasmodium, okay, later on they form a stalk, okay, in bahasa tangkai, okay. That stalk is a fruiting body that later on will produce spores. After being released, okay, after the spores being released, okay, the spores open and the haploid amoeboid cell will emerge, okay. This process we call as asexual reproduction. The haploid amoeboid cell that have been emerged from the spores, they can survive as the feeding stage because, as we know, that the amoeba character, they have a structure that can help them to move, okay. So they can survive to look for food by themselves, okay. But the other life cycle, okay, as we compare to the previous plasmodial slime mold, the spores can form into amoeboid cell and also flagellated cell. But for this cellular slime mold, the life cycle is lack of flagellated stage. Means in this type of mold, the cellular slime mold, they prefer to produce amoeboid cell compared to flagellated stage. Okay, the life cycle of Dictyostelium, a cellular slime mold. So you can remember this genus name, Dictyostelium sp, okay, as an example for cellular slime mold. We go for the blue cycle first. So it starts from the solitary amoeba's feeding stage, okay. So this organism, they will start to enlarge or aggregate, okay, aggregate by forming pseudoplasmodium, okay, like the previous slide. So you can refer the previous slide. So this later on they will migrate, okay, to enlarge the networking, and they will form a fruiting bodies, a stalk-like structure. These fruiting bodies containing the spores, okay, the spore will be released, okay. Of course, the spores is haploid. The genotype is haploid. Later on, these spores will emerge into amoeboid cell, which is this amoeboid cell, they can move by themselves. Okay, now the amoeboid cell also known as the gamete, okay. The gamete, later on, if they want to do the sexual reproduction, they will look for another gamete, another amoeboid cell, and do the fertilization, or call as syngamy. Okay, after they fertilize and the genotype become diploid, say they form into zygote. So this zygote is diploid. During the sexual reproduction, two haploid amoebas will fuse and form a zygote. Okay, so the zygote will become a giant cell, okay, by consuming haploid amoebas after developing a resistant wall. The giant cell undergoes meiosis followed by several mitotic division, okay, and then later on they form into amoebas, okay, amoeba cell, and then the cycle repeatedly. Okay, now we go to the last phylum, Oomycota, or the common call as water moles. So this organism, they have sinocytic mycelium. What do you understand by sinocytic mycelium? Okay, synostatic mycelium is referring to the structure of hyphae. Do you remember the hyphae? Okay, the hyphae, a thread-like structure called hyphae. Okay, that structure, normally they have a septa. Septa is the separator between one to another. Okay, so in this water mold, the hyphae doesn't have any septa. That's why they call as synostatic, aseptic. Aseptic means A from the word A means it does not have septic, septa. So this organism doesn't have septa in their mycelium. Mycelium is the hyphae. Okay, the other character for this organism, the cell wall is composed either cellulose, chitin or both. And they reproduce asexually by forming a zoospore when the food is plentiful. When there is favorable condition, they will do the asexual reproduction by forming zoospores. But when the environmental condition is worsened or unfavorable, they will do the sexual reproduction and forming the oospore. Okay, from this slide, okay, there are two examples of the water moles, Saprolegnia sp and Phytophthora infestans. Okay, we go to the life cycle of a water mole. Okay, so this is the life cycle of the water mole. They have sexual reproduction during the worsened condition, and normally they reproduce by asexual. Okay, we go into the first step, encysted zoospores. What is the meaning by encysted zoospores? Encysted zoospores mean the spores already shed its flagellum. Okay, dia dah ada flagellum kat sini. And the membrane, okay, forming a wall cyst. Okay, membrane dia membentuk wall cyst. That is the meaning of encysted zoospore. It start shed their flagellum and the membrane, okay, forming a wall cyst. So these zoospores, it will land on the substrate and germinate and growing into hyphae. Okay. Several days later, the hyphae begins to form the sexual structures. Okay, they start to form sexual structures because they want to undergo into sexual reproduction. So, to complete this process, meiosis takes place. So, the meiosis will produce eggs within the oogonia. And on the separate branches of the hyphae or same hyphae, it can be different hyphae or the same hyphae, the meiosis also takes place and produce several haploid sperm that contain within the antenatal hyphae. Okay, so now the cell already have oogonium and consists eggs and also the sperm. So they will undergo the process of fertilization, the fusion of the eggs and sperm. So how the fertilization takes place? Okay, the antenatal hyphae will grow like hooks around the oogonium and deposit their nuclei through fertilization tubes that lead to the eggs. So these antenatal hyphae, they form one tube, okay, that protrude into the eggs to deliver the nuclei or the genetic material from the sperm. Okay, so following fertilization, the zygote or the oospores may develop resistant wall but are also protected within the wall of the oogonium. So when they fertilize, they will form another wall, okay, that contain both the genetic material. And then the later, a dormant period follows. Okay, so kat sini ialah dormant period, maksudnya inactive. Dia tidak akan germinate until it reach the good condition to grow. Okay, so during this stage, the oogonium will disintegrate and they will release the dormant or the dormant seed atau the dormant apa ni zygote. And the zygote will germinate when they reach favorable condition such as water or nutrients to live. So this is the sexual reproduction in water moles. There is on this process is only happen when the condition is worse. Okay, so from the zygote germination, this is the asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is a common process that this organism belongs to. So from the zygote, it will germinate, okay, into the hyphae. Okay, so this hyphae, how the hyphae is reproduced asexually, it will form a tubular zoosporangia. Okay, so this zoosporangium will produce about 30 biflagellated zoospore asexually. Biflagellated means they have two flagella. So this zoospore, they have two flagella, and later on they will form into cysts. Okay, that's all for the life cycle of water moles. So what is important in this slide, you must know the character of the sexual reproduction, okay, how the fertilization happen, and the genotype of each cell representing. Okay, and then for the asexual reproduction is a common process for this organism, and you have no type of process happen. For example, when is the mitosis process, when is the meiosis takes place, and then what type of the zoospore it have. Okay, for example, some species, they prefer to form a gamete in the form of amoeboid and flagellated cell. Some of the cell, they only prefer amoeboid cell. Okay, for example, in this water mole, the gamete in the form, the spores in the form of zoospores, which they have a flagella, which is different from the other two slime mole. So basically, we have finished the chapter 4 for protists. Okay, so I hope for this fungi-like protists, you can do your summary in the form of table. Please list all the characteristics and all the common features for each organism with examples and the uses of each organism. Okay, the benefit or even it cause any diseases to human. Okay, and then that table will help you to summary all the information in this chapter so that you do not confuse about the information. Okay, that's all. So thank you.